You know it's fine. I go, oh, hey, maybe there isn't a right.
Gary and Shannon. It's only out of sight. A reminder, today until 6 o'clock, the LA Chargers are offering you a way to help the thousands of families suffering between Texas and Louisiana because of Hurricane Harvey. Until 6 o'clock tonight, they're going to be out at the Vons Grocery Store at 4520 Sunset. Joey Bosa, Hunter Henry, Drew Kaser, Rayshon Jenkins, the new kicker, Younghoe Koh, is going to be out there. Russell Okung, Derek Watt, brother JJ. What?
Youngway.
What did I say?
I don't know.
I said Younghoe Koh. It's Youngway?
Youngway Koh.
Got it. Head coach Anthony Lynn's going to be out there. All of them taking supplies to be put onto a giant truck or two or six and taken down to help the people out of Hurricane Harvey.
Hey, how did this story get in our pile? Can you sneak that one in there?
It's that kind of a day.
It is.
What else is going on?
Time for What's Happening.
Hurricane Irma is happening. Irma has the trifecta, shall I say. She's got the warm water, the moisture in the mid-atmosphere, the absence of vertical wind shear. Those three things combined to give you a category 5 storm. They're saying Irma is the strongest hurricane in the Atlantic Basin outside of the Caribbean Sea and the Gulf of Mexico in the record books.
Yeah, we're watching some of the networks who have people on the island of Puerto Rico getting ready for what's coming. And it's hard for me to, I don't know what the strongest wind gust I've ever been in. I mean, some storms that we covered up in Seattle were pretty significant, 50, 60 mile an hour winds. But they're talking 185 mile an hour winds that will blow down homes here in Southern California that are designed to withstand earthquakes would blow apart like splinters in 185 mile an hour.
That's winds. Incredible. That's an excellent analogy.
It's over Puerto Rico right now, but over the course of the next several days, by this weekend, it's going to be impacting Florida somehow. Whether it just brushes by or if the eye goes all the way and, you know, devastates Miami, it's a possibility.
So. NFL has moved the Buccaneers-Dolphins game until the two teams have their bye weeks, week 11.
So they're just getting a week off to start the season instead of later on.
It is in the news. When does this movie come out? Tomorrow?
Friday.
Friday. Okay. So somebody in Lancaster County, Pennsylvania has tied a red balloon to a storm drain. I think that's hysterical and brilliant and comic genius. You said,
I think it's terrifying. Terrifying.
When you see the red balloon at a storm drain, though, you know it's somebody, you know, making a joke. You don't actually think the clown's in there, do you?
Doesn't matter. It does not matter.
What's scarier? When Halloween was coming around and all the people were dressing up as clowns and just standing on the street corner.
Like, there was somebody who did that here.
Yeah. Or just the balloon. What's more frightening to you?
Just the balloon.
I almost think it would depend on the location of the balloon. Like, is it on a major street? You know, is it on Victory Boulevard here in the Valley? Or is it just on one little cul-de-sac?
Or like when you walk out of your house. It's just right there.
Stop it.
Or just a little post-it when you get home from work on your door that says you'll float too.
I love it.
Red Sox are in the news. The Red Sox have reportedly used an Apple Watch to steal signs from the Yankees.
Okay. The watch didn't steal the signs. The argument is someone in the dugout was watching their watch. Someone watching the telecast was catching the signs from the catcher, sending them to somebody in the dugout who's wearing an Apple Watch, and then relaying that to the hitter.
Oh, no.
I have a question.
Jim Mora will ban all Apple products.
As I have not been in a locker room during a game,
yes,
which I don't know if either of you have,
mm-hmm.
The game, because what they said was it was someone in the back in the locker room watching the game feed.
Yeah.
Is that one not on delay?
No.
Because everything we see at home is on delay.
Yeah, no, not the screens.
There's no delay whatsoever.
I don't think there's a delay when you watch it at home.
There's a couple seconds.
maybe transmission time, but that you're talking, I mean,
but, okay, but how
mere
long
moments.
You, but how long do you have between a sign going down and the swing? You have 3 seconds.
Yeah.
It's long enough.
That's what I'm saying, though. But between my house and Dodger Stadium,
right,
that I wouldn't be able to relay anything fast enough with that transmission delay.
No, but I see what you're saying. So what the Red Sox said was, hey, we're only doing what the Yankees have done. Because what they say the Yankees do is they have an actual hardline feed from that center field camera into the locker room that doesn't go through the normal yes broadcast. What they're saying is they get it in absolute real time and can relay it in the 1 or 2 or 4 seconds or whatever between the sign and the actual delivery of the pitch. So the Red Sox are saying we only did it because the Yankees did it.
That's a terrible defense.
Here's the thing.
There's
no rule against stealing signs in baseball. Zero. You just cannot use electronic means to do so. If the guy on second base, runner on second base, happens to steal the signs and relay them to the pitcher or the batter, there's nothing illegal about that. It's a douchey move.
That's why you throw it at his head.
That's why you throw it at his head.
Walmart exactly. has come out with holiday toys. Yes, I know. It's September 6th. We haven't even dressed up like the clown for Halloween yet.
I haven't even had my first pumpkin spice latte yet.
I love the voice you take on when you talk about pumpkin spice lattes.
It's annoying.
Hatchimals surprise.
It's going to be a surprise.
Details
to be released on October 6th.
Are you going to want to get a Star Wars droid adventure kit?
I don't think so.
How about a fur real friends, Roran Tyler, the playful tiger?
No.
Barbie dream house and doll?
Probably not.
Absolutely.
I already have a dream horse and doll.
House.
Horse.
Tinder poo is in the news.
Why is Tinder?
I don't
poo in the
know.
News,
you
Maya?
Put this in the news.
Well,
this is a good one.
This is a story
snuck
that
snuck this in.
I don't know about I snuck it in, but it's about doo doo.
Once I went in the restroom, they locked me in there for like 45 minutes. There was doo doo feces thrown all over the walls,
stunk so bad,
the floor, the ceiling, and it stunk so bad.
All right,
a woman who went to the toilet in her date's house had to be rescued after reportedly getting stuck in the window while trying to retrieve her own poo that would not flush. Quick gas go around, everybody.
Oh my god.
Yes, sir.
Why are you doing this?
Who has been in the home of somebody else, maybe of the, usually of the opposite sex.
A romantic prospect.
When they went, they felt that feeling where they had to go number two. Blake.
Have I ever had to? Yes.
And did it ever get stuck?
No. That happened at a Christmas party, though.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
And?
There's a story.
Well, it wasn't stuck in a window. It was stuck in the toilet.
Did you get the plunger?
They didn't have a plunger.
What did you do?
Well, luckily it was like family friends. So I went to the husband. I was like, dude, there's, I don't know what you like. And he grabbed the toilet brush and used that as a plunger.
Oh, no. That is not a plunger.
Oh, it worked.
Oscar Ramirez.
Yes and no.
Yes, you what?
Anymore.
I've had to be at somebody else's house.
Yeah.
No, it didn't get stuck.
Oh. All right. Congratulations.
Were you worried that it would, though? There's a moment of anxiety, wasn't there?
No, I was very conscious about it, and I was going to not make a mess, so.
Yeah. Because normally you would if you didn't think about it?
No, I'm just, you know.
You trust the commode sciences.
Right, exactly.
Amy King.
Yes and no.
All right.
Yes and no.
Am I going to be the one?
Yeah. Are you a yes and yes?
Is this article about you?
It was one time. It was a cabin in the mountains.
Oh, horrible plumbing.
Yes.
In the cabin.
Yeah. It wasn't me.
Was it your fault, Shannon?
What do you mean it wasn't you?
Did you make a big deal out of it?
Apparently she did make a big deal.
Yeah,
how was it resolved?
It was my husband's family's cabin, and we were all up there.
Before marriage?
Before marriage.
And he still?
I know. And, okay, so they went on a walk.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, no, I'm cool. I think I could go on a walk. Right? Because I'm a lady. Right? And then that happened. and the plumbing situation happened. But there was a plunger.
So you took care of it.
But I was in tears.
So nobody knew about it.
I was crying.
Until just now.
I didn't know if that would work. Right? And then the family's going to come back. Crazy girlfriend.
Overflowing
the
toilet.
This is the thing.
You see how red my face is just talking about it, just reliving that?
In this story, the girl did it, couldn't the plumbing sciences didn't work. Mm. She grabbed it, threw it out the window. It got stuck on the ledge outside the window. Then she confesses to the guy, hey, this is very awkward. I did this, and it's outside the window. And he says, I'll help you get it. I don't know why at that point you help her do anything.
Well, because she was a gymnast, so she said she could do it.
Leave it on the windowsill.
But then you'd have to look at it every day.
Nope.
The window's right there by the toilet.
This is in Bristol. There's plenty of rain in Bristol.
No, it wasn't outside.
Yeah, well, yeah, it was
in between panes.
Oh, no.
It was stuck in the window.
No.
Yeah.
Have you looked at pictures? Down, it's just on the outside of the window, but it didn't go over the ledge.
It fell down into
the
narrow
floor.
Gap between her window and the next window, the neighboring property.
Oh, God.
Firefighters had to be called because she got stuck.
She was outside, with her feet stuck up in the air, dangling outside the window.
Those poor firefighters. They see so much.
Hmm. That, you think there's a future for that relationship?
Do you think they'll go for number two?
God, that is so terrible.
You think they'll go for number two, she said. No. We're done. We are done.
Oh, God. All right. Let's talk about
anything.
Carrie and Shannon, KFI.